for quite a change of scene, the next poem called Buckaroo Vang by Jim Cardwell. Let's give him a warm welcome.
Thank you. This poem celebrates the diversity of America's immigrant spirit, one of the more recent threads in the American fabric is the Laotian Hmong, Buckaroo Vang. The kid got his name in the darndest way, and I'm the one who should know. Without me, that Laotian kid wouldn't be riding rodeo. I had worked in emergency rooms for just about 20 years. Every conceivable crisis had dampened my deepest fears, except for one, that dreadful event, the second stage of labor. Terror from sheer insecurity cut through me like a saber. The first stage is best, a brainless response. You just take them to OB. There's nothing to fear, no cleanup chores, and nothing you don't want to see. The third stage is a breeze. Tension is past. Events have mostly resolved. The second stage is dangerous ground. My confidence dissolved. Now, I've seen my fair share of birth and calves, using both ropes and chains. But when it comes to human beings, the encounter just ain't the same. Buck's mother arrived as New Year's told, sprawled out in the back of a van. The way she clutched her abdomen would chill an ordinary man. I grabbed a chair and wheeled her to the nearest elevator. "Baby coming," she calmly moaned. I'd start the paperwork later. How many babies have you had?" I asked as the door sealed my fate. Bracing her legs and leaning back hard, she managed to mutter, "8." I donned a pair of latex gloves, then heard a horrifying squeak. The algorithm of maternity required that I take a peek. Eyeball to eyeball, I gawked at a face, and not a happy one. Locked alone with this crowning event, I acted under the gun. The smock that I wore on this New Year's Eve was all the linen I had. Sooner than I could pull it off, the second stage turned really bad. With one final push, Buck arrived like a breaker thrown from a mount. The chute flew open and he shot out, about a 2-second count. I scooped him midair with my right hand draped by the disarranged smock. He bounced a bit off the wheelchair's frame, thus took his first hard knock. Then, like a football wide receiver pulling in a rain slick ball, I tucked the bundle to my chest, preventing a harder fall. His arms were strong. His cry was hearty. His face a nice rosy hue. I welcomed this handsome newcomer. "You're right, strong buckaroo." Unknown to me, his mama believed that the name bestowed on a son should be the first word spoken to him when his earthly days begun. So, Buckaroo, his name would be. There never would be remorses. And sure enough, since he first talked, the thing he loved most were... You got it. Now, it may seem a strange career for a second generation Hmong, but for a young man named Buckaroo, any other would be wrong. He's rising fast, a golden lad in the saddle bronc category. And now that you've heard it straight from me, you know the rest of the story.
Thank you.